the Jack Refix.
What is going on, everybody? Thank you guys for joining me. I'm JP Storm with GamingAuthority.com, and in this video, maybe you guys know how to do this, but I'm going to go over how to stop slant patterns, how to stop your opponent from doing slant patterns, and also throw a little curveball to it and make that defense against slants even better, and I'll show you. You can do this with any defense. Now, I'm in the, I see the offenses in slants. I'm in just like a basic cover two. I think at 3-4 odd. So, maybe you guys know this, but cross manning is like the best way to defend for slant patterns. So, what I mean is, but you're going to know your opponent and what he likes to do throughout the game, so you got to keep an eye on that, keep a mental note of what your opponent likes to do and where he likes to throw the slant and to who, so you're going to know if it's circle or if it's X. So what we're going to do, or if it's a slot, we're going to take this linebacker, man him up on triangle, then we're going to take this guy, man him up on circle, let's just say circle, and that this is cross manning. When the two linebackers or whoever you guys got crossing each other's paths to get to the other receiver. And it works fantastic. Look, nobody looks open. Nobody looks open. Nobody looks open till it's too late. So that is the effect of it. So again, you want to cross man. You take this guy, man him up on circle, man him up on the slot. And again, look where, see how they move. Like everything looks covered. Let me just go into instant replay. And again, some of you guys might know this, but maybe some of you is beginners, maybe you just don't. But let's take a look at the linebacker. Hold on. You see, they did their cross right there. And now look at the slot. Never looks covered because of the other linebacker who's waiting for circle to come by. So everybody looks covered here if those are the main guys. I mean, even the other receiver, Dez Bryant. Everybody looks covered, and that's what you want here. Now I'm going to take this one step further to make this an even more confusing of a defense. Okay, you're going to do your cross man. Your opponent likes to do slant routes. So you're going to cross man him up. You know how to defeat it. You're going to cross man. So you're going to do that. Also, see these two deep blue safeties? And I don't suggest doing this all the time. But man him up on the outside receiver. Man him up on the outside receiver. So now the two outside receivers are double covered. And the tight end, everybody's covered except the running back, which you can maybe manually do that yourself with this linebacker who is on a blitz. Maybe you could do that yourself. Everybody's covered. But look at this coverage, though. It's a very exotic. Like, nobody's open there. Nobody is open, especially on slants. So now you have people double covered. You have everybody. Look, you have everybody in the middle of the field. Now, I'm not suggesting always run it like that, but once in a while, to confuse your opponent. I mean, look at this. I mean, tell me who's open. Nobody, except there for a little bit, the slot. But look how long it took him to get open. Look at that. Everybody is covered. So that's just a different, weird, little exotic look to that blitz, which I'm sure a lot of people have not seen. I just think it's a very, very good, confusing way of running your off, running your defense. Everybody's covered. Even let's say you want to... Ah, sorry about that. Let's say we're going to just not do slants, but formation, 3-4 odd. Any type of cover two man like that you could do. So I'm going to double coverage the outside. I'm going to cross man. Look what you got. Now if the halfback's open, I would man him up. Now look. Everybody is covered. And I'm not even doing slant patterns here. Look, the offense is doing something different. So I like it. Double covering with the safeties and then cross manning. So now you have the two. The outside receivers are double covered. They would be triple covered if you put cross man on circle. Then if that is the case, then maybe take him and put him on the tight end. So now the tight end's double covered, the two outside receivers are double covered, and the slot is just single covered. But look, nobody is open there. So I'm not suggesting always run that type of defense, but throw that in, mix it up. I mean, if it's confusing to your opponent, then you're only going to force him to make mistakes or hold the ball because he's not used to seeing that. So this is a very confusing way. So it's not just about slant patterns. Slants we covered, which, you know, it's late in the year. Everybody knows about that. And if you don't, I hope this helped you. But it's also a little bit of an exotic, weird type of coverage that most of your opponents won't see. Don't abuse it. Because you have somebody like Dez Bryant, you know, that they'll just, or Julio Jones, they just bomb it up. And so you want to have the deep blue back there every once in a while. But I'm just saying, just a different look for your opponent, because you give him different looks. You don't become predictable, which means he can't just do what he wants on offense. So like the video, subscribe to us. I hope this helped. So if it did help, show me those likes, baby. Come on. And thank you guys for watching. I appreciate it. The Jack Refix.